WYPR. Now, back to midday. And now, a big treat here on Midday. My next guest is the iconic singer, actress, and television star Freda Payne. She'll be appearing this weekend at Keystone Corner, the terrific jazz club in the Harbor East neighborhood here in Baltimore. Freda Payne had her first gold record hit back in 1970 with Band of Gold. She's appeared on stage, in films. She hosted a TV show. She's worked with a who's who of performers, including Duke Ellington, Bob Hope, Frank Sinatra, Sammy Davis Jr., Pearl Bailey, Omar Sharif, Quincy Jones, Liza Minnelli, and Sarah Vaughan, and that's just naming a few. Here's the opening verse of the great jazz standard, You Can't Take That Away From Me, which she recorded in 2019 with Johnny Mathis.
The way you wear your hat, the way you sip your tea, the memory of all that, no, they can't take that away from me. The way your smile just beams, the way you sing off key, the way you haunt my dreams. No, no, they can't take that away from me.
Freda Payne just celebrated her 81st birthday. She'll be at Keystone Corner on Saturday and Sunday. She joins us now on Zoom from Los Angeles. Ms. Payne, it is an honor to speak with you.
Oh, thank you, Tom Hall. It's an honor to speak with you as well.
Because I tell you, you know how to sell a song. My Lord, you know how to sell a song. And
well, I love it.
I mean, and, you know, you're playing a jazz club here in Baltimore that Todd Barkin, a wonderful NEA jazz master, has opened for the last several years. Jazz is really kind of coming home for you, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. I started singing jazz as a teenager back in Detroit. At the age of 13, 14, 15, I sang with big bands. I sang on the radio. I sang with Quincy Jones' big band in the 60s. So, you know, and my first LP, although people know me for Band of Gold, which was a huge hit, which was a gold record for me in 1970. And I had a second gold record, and that was Bring the Boys Home. But some people don't realize that I'm really a jazz singer, but that's okay because I can do it all. I do a conglomeration of music taste.
Yeah, you sure can. And to say nothing of the fact that you're also an actor. I mean, you started in the business as a model back in the day. You hosted a TV show. Was it a conscious decision to sort of make sure you were covering the waterfront like that? So many people want to specify and, you know, concentrate on one thing. They're happy to be kind of, you know, plugged as this kind of thing. I'm a pop singer. I'm an R&B singer. I'm a jazz singer. I'm an actor. It seems to me you made a conscious choice to do everything.
Oh, yeah. There was a point where I could have paid more attention to being an actress. But then I realized that I had better advantage if I, you know, just worked on being a singer. So I'm glad I made that choice because, after all, I mean, I still do both anyway. I think I was like about 14 or 15 when I decided I'd just stick to singing. And that's what really took off because I worked more as a singer than an actress anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And that's only if I'd gotten it to like one of those episodic TV series or anything like that, then that would have made a difference. But I enjoy singing. That's my thrill. My real thrill.
Yeah, you know, and I was in the music business and in the singing business. I was a classical choral conductor before I started doing broadcast journalism full time. So for about 40 years, I conducted choirs and orchestras and operas and whatnot. And
really?
Yeah. And one of the things that always impressed me about certain artists is their longevity. You are singing well into your 80s now, and to do that as a singer is not easy. It's one thing to be a violinist or a pianist or, you know, an instrumentalist who can still negotiate the instrument, but to keep the instrument of the voice as fresh and as beautiful and as flexible as yours is, shows that you have incredible technique.
Well, you know, also, I presume, because I'm not a smoker, I never was a cigarette smoker, and I like to drink a little bit of wine now and then. I'll have a glass of wine or half a glass of wine now and then, or, you know, to relax me in the evening. But I guess, and then, of course, I vocalize. And then my niece is a vocal coach, by the way. Mm-hmm. And her name is Shoshana Payne Phillips. And she has a studio. It's called La Voix Studio here in Studio City. And sometimes I go and I say, hey, Shoshana, let's do a session. And she'll, like, work me out, vocalize. You know, they call it vocalises. And she'll, like, vocal, you know, work me out with that. So all you have to do, if you're a mature, and by the way, although I just turned 81, I hated it when I turned 80 because I couldn't believe I said, am I that old? You know, I couldn't believe it. It was like, wait a minute now, where have all these years gone by? And here I am now 81. And of course, most people can't believe it because they think I look like I'm about 50.
You do. And you sound like you're 50, you know, you sound like you're 30. I mean, that's the thing. If you ever want to convince yourself that you're not old, just put on a record.
Yeah, I know. But you know what? Like they say, look, you gotta keep up your looks. Although some people, and then again, I feel it has a lot to do with your DNA, your genetics.
Mm-hmm.
Your genetics. And then there, of course, everybody knows you can get work done and this and that and tucks and nips. You know, I do little things, you know, like maybe Botox or something like that, or filler, which is a normal thing for a lot of women. I know girls start doing that stuff in their 20s. I can't believe it.
It's wild.
You know, I never did Botox until I was in my 50s.
Yeah. Well, you didn't need it. You probably don't need it now, but that's my humble opinion. But, when you're working and traveling, you really got to take care of yourself. I mean, the singer's instrument is her body. And it's not just the throat. It's the rest of the package, too. You've got to fly from the West Coast to the East Coast. You got to deal with jet lag. You got to do shows on, you know, Saturday and Sunday here at Keystone Corner. That takes some paying attention to, doesn't it?
Yeah, I have to say for advice is you just have to roll with the punches. Some people, you know, wind up having joint replacements, and I have knee replacement, shoulder, you know, that kind of stuff. But hey, that stuff heals, and you just go on like it's 30 years ago, and you just do your thing.
Well, you know, attitude is everything, and that's terrific.
Attitude is everything, and I feel like I've been reborn again.
Well, we are delighted that you're going to be here in Baltimore. The great Freda Payne, she'll be at Keystone Corner for two shows, Saturday night at 7, Sunday at 5. You can stream them, or you can show up in person. Ms. Payne, thank you so much. I'm really delighted for the opportunity to talk to you.
Oh, thank you so much, Tom. I would love it if you were to attend as well.
Well, you know, we're going to work on that. We are going to work on that.
All right.
All right. Thanks so much. Take care now.
Okay. Thank you.
And listeners, I do want to remind you we are in the last day of our fall membership campaign.